On this episode of Haunted Hotel, we'll visit the Crescent.
Tonight I feel ambitious and so does my foot. As it sinks on the pedal, I press it to the floor. I don't need a girl, don't need a friend, 'cause my friend Lonesome's unconditional. We're flying forever bored.
So Guy Keane, what do you think of this place? You digging it?
Doesn't smell bad. It just smells pretty good.
Yes, it does.
The room sucks.
Yeah.
It looks like it's about to fall down.
It's true. And we've got you've got all these pretty little designs here. Then you go up here and all of a sudden they're just not there.
Because it's
and
crappy.
Then we got the, oh, look, we got this going on and oh, it's gone.
Ooh, and it's crappy. Oops.
Oh, well, we do have dust in it. Now this bottle right here, this little thing right here, it's water. And guess how much it costs if you open it? It's $8.
Eight.
So Dustin, Dustin Malin, what do you think of this place?
I think it's overpriced.
Yeah. How much do we pay for this room?
$200.
That's a lot.
Yeah, it is.
Is it worth it?
Not really. Pretty cool, but...
So what do you think? Are we going to see ghosts tonight or what?
I don't know. Maybe.
You believe?
I don't believe, but I don't disbelieve.
If you see
have
one...
Open mind.
If you see one, you... I gotcha. Alrighty.
You, like, insult the room or something? Like some woman will...
You being serious?
Yeah, no, I'm not
being serious. And we're here insulting it?
That's why I remembered it, because you guys are sitting here like, it looks like the walls are all torn up.
And well, scary. I don't know.
It's like supposedly some...
Well, I think this room's disgusting, personally. I just think it's trash.
Like, throw your clothes everywhere or some junk like that.
I have heard that. My little brother did that.
I can throw my own
clothes. I don't believe it either, because... I guess they're going to have to prove it for themselves.
This place sucks.
I know, it's horrible. It's trash in here.
What do you think? What do you think the ghost would do if I just
punched a hole in the wall or something.
I don't know, probably punch back.
Punch back.
Yes, I lived there for about a month and a half.
Within
the hotel, second floor.
I have not stayed there, but I've seen it regularly over the last 35 years. So I've seen it in great disrepair, and I've seen the enormous efforts that the recent owners have made to improve the hotel.
When I lived there, I got tired of people like coming to my room because the door didn't lock. The tourists always come around looking for ghosts and all that, so I started sleeping naked to give them a surprise. That's
scary.
Yeah, it's the most eventful thing there was, I guess.
Not at the Crescent. Generally, I'm too activated to spend time. You need quiet time in order to sense the presence of a poltergeist or something like that. So that's why I had much more of those experiences while living in Crystal Terrace alone or in my own place. I have a Masonic temple upstairs that was built in 1897, and it was quite a haunted place as well.
Oh, absolutely. They, when I first arrived, I mean, people would talk about people who stayed there had heard noises, people who have visited have seen various apparitions, is that the word? Sightings of ghost-like creatures. I think that it is a very old structure, which would probably lend itself to odd noises in the middle of the night anyway, but maybe the ghost lives there, I don't know.
Yeah, there's always the ghost stories of the Crescent. I forgot all the particulars of any of the ghost stories. Room 216 or something up there usually has to do with workmen who have died in the process of rebuilding. It used to be a girls' school, I hear, back in the early 1900s, mid-1900s, and some lady fell out or jumped out a window or something of the sort. I don't know all the ghost stories. A lot of them are attributed to Dr. Baker. Dr. Baker's cancer hospital, when it was a cancer hospital, you know, a lot of people died there. He was still taking in the money and, you know, shipping them out.
Well, there's a lot of history about it, going back to supposedly one of the stonemasons that died there that often is attributed to a lot of the ghost stories of Michael. But again, that's just one tragic death, and what's probably many, many other tragic deaths that people aren't even aware of or remember. The hotel itself has had a lot of activity during the Baker years in the late 30s and early 40s. Dr. Baker there had a cancer treatment, and people would come there and die, and they would put him on ice while they collected monthly fees from their family until the family came to visit them. Then they'd roll the corpse out and say, "Oh, we're so sorry, your loved one had just passed away." But until the family came, they kept the corpse on ice, so there's probably a lot of angry people.
Oh, well, it was built, there's in the lobby, there is a commemorative plaque. It was built as a hotel, and it was a very extravagant gesture, but then at the turn of the century, I mean, people came here for the curative waters, and a great many people came here in 1900. As a matter of fact, I mean, there's a resident population now in 2006 of about 2,000 people, and which has been about 2,000 people for 30 years, but in 1900, they said that there were like 10,000 people who lived in this town, which is huge compared to now. So there was a demand. People would come on the train to drink the waters to cure various ailments. It, of course, modern medicine caught up with that theory, and in 1920, the hotel had fallen on hard times and became the Crescent College for Girls. And it was the Crescent College for Girls for a number of years. Not a huge number, but I'll guess, say 10 years. And then after that, it limped along as a hotel and through various owners. And it just kept falling into disrepair. And actually, the Rennicks, when they bought it, have put a tremendous amount of money in it and have sort of brought it back.
Not really. I don't keep up with most of the ghost stories. I've never actually been on the ghost tour up the Crescent. I think most of the ghost stories involve the Crescent Hotel. And I believe there was a house that used to be Dr. Baker's house, some other gentleman. They were on Ghost Finders or something like that on Sci-Fi Network like a year ago, so Ghost Hunters, and so something about his house. I remember them having their cameras and going out into the woods in the area and, you know, getting glimpses of deer, I think. That's about it.
Oh, well, actually, the Palace Hotel is quite a haunted little boutique hotel built in 1901. It only has 8 suites. I lived there for a while. I've always had the same residence on Pendergrass Corner, but I sometimes enjoy hotel life, especially if the hotel owner owes me money.
There was a doctor that used to, or a fake doctor, he was a fraud, and he had a nurse that used, and they had cancer patients, and they said that they could fix people with cancer, and what they'd do is they would just keep them here until they died, and then when they died, they'd put them on ice, and then so they would keep getting money out of their families and stuff. And then whenever they finally call their families, and whenever their families came to see them, they'd be like, well, your daughter or whatever family member died, we're sorry or whatever, and they'd show them the body. And but I guess there was a nurse that used to push the bodies down the hallway after they died, and everybody had to go to bed at 9 o'clock because they do that after 10. And supposedly in the hall in this floor, which is the 3rd floor, there's a nurse that pushes a gurney down the hallway.
All right, so we're going to go out to the hallway and film at 10 o'clock for the lady that walks through the hall with dead bodies, right? And we're going to use the regular camera on one, and then we're going to go night vision at the other end of the hallway, because the way a night vision camera works is it sends out like radar waves, and then it bounces off of whatever and sends them back. So we're hoping that maybe if the regular camera doesn't catch her, that the radar will.
Well, it's 10 o'clock, and we're looking for her. This is the nurse lady.
Hey, are you picking up the stain on the floor here? There's 2 of them. Here.
Girl that was in this room, I guess one night, she went out on the balcony that's just right behind Blake and actually jumped off the balcony and died. And I guess her name was Annabelle, but here they call her the Lady in White.
My name's Brian, born right here in Eureka Springs, Arkansas, and we're right in front of 319.
Our room.
Okay, and this room right here, one day I was headed back off the back side of the building, and I heard a thump in the bushes right behind me, and showing up about that time was a young lady, and she came over and she started talking to me, and the first thing she told me is that my grandmother is correct about who pushed her off the balcony. Okay, and the second thing that she told me was that her name was Annabelle. And I don't like going off the back side of the building over here because somebody usually follows me down the staircase, and that's where I'm parked tonight. So, whenever I head out, usually someone will follow me out that direction. The other night, it was my friend Joe who used to wash dishes down here. And he was kind of teasing me as I went down the staircase. So he's hanging out in the building now, too. Okay. So, but that's Annabelle. She falls off of this balcony.
Well, it's almost that time. We got one more chance to find another a ghost. And this one supposedly jumps off the ledge right here. I guess she falls down in these bushes. I guess we'll find out. We got Guy camped out with the night vision over here. You can see him. Got Keen over there. We're just waiting. So what do you think, Dustin? You think we're going to see anything?
I don't know. I kind of have a feeling we're not going to.
Well, we'll see. We'll see.
Say what? Oh, it's going all right. I'm just talking to Brooke right now. Oh my goodness, your camera's flashing at me. Are you moving it?
Well, it is 10:35 and we have seen nothing of this lady in white. So, Guy Keen, do you see anything?
No. Absolutely nothing.
Well, hey, it was a good try.
We caught a few unexplainable things while filming. Here's just a few of them. Now, I want you to pay close attention to the painting behind Virgil. You see how it moves? Here on camera 2, there are no visible stains on the floor. But as we switch to our night vision camera, camera 1, there are clearly 2 visible stains. Now I want you to pay close attention to this clip. Do you see anything abnormal? Now watch again. Pay close attention to the TV. You may see something startling.
Dustin, you ready to go home?
Yeah.
Guy, you ready to go home? Blake, how did the trip go overall?
I don't think we saw any ghosts. I think we caught a couple things maybe on tape in the background that we're going to have to look at closer when we get home. But there was nothing really that just was stuck out that we saw a ghost. We didn't see a girl jump off our balcony. And it seems to me like we had one of the best rooms for this place, and we didn't see anything. So, but I guess we'll see when we get home if we got anything. So it was alright.
Dustin, how do you think the trip went overall?
It was alright. It was pretty fun. The room we stayed in, like Blake said, seemed like it would have been the best room to stay in, but didn't really see anything. You know, it's alright. Kinda figured we weren't going to, but overall it was pretty fun. It was a pretty good trip, so.
So Guy Keen, what do you think of the little adventure?
Well, like Dustin said already, it was fun. And like Blake said already, we probably had one of the best rooms and still didn't see anything. So I don't think that the hotel's really haunted. I think most of it's fabricated. But still a good time.
It was a good time. Good time.
Step one, you say we need to talk. He walks, you say sit down, it's just talk. He smiles politely.
Alright. There's some lady giving a tour of ghosts up there, and Dustin's about to hit the door and see somebody screaming.
Go ahead. Not too hard, but go ahead. Pretty hard, though. Just do it. Yeah, go for a scratch and then bang on it. Someone saying something? That's good.